Today I will talk about photogrammetry and how we can take the shootings with Virtual Stick and DJI Mutable Missions. I created a new map tool where we can have 3D spherical maps, 2D maps and also Inception, and we can see them on Google Earth. It is important that for photogrammetry we have optimized grids to do the shootings. And this example I took last year was made with a 2D grid and a 3D grid, all with one battery with the Mavic Pro 2. So I will explain the difference between Virtual Stick and also the inbuilt DJI Mutable function. So we will use a point of interest mission, and we will also use a trigger for distance to take the photos, which is working on both systems, Virtual Stick and also the DJI Mutable mission. I built a new app creator or editor in Xcode, native Xcode, without any frameworks. So I can do the 2D and the 3D mapping as I like to do it for Virtual Stick and also for Mutable missions. It's working on OS X, Mac OS or iOS. This app will be soon in the store for macOS and also iOS 14. It's very easy to do the 3D missions with only a few waypoints. There was no alternative on the market, so I built this app. It's also compatible with the CSV Excel import-export for Litchi, so we can have edit functions also out of the box. And I use iCloud Drive to have direct access into the app from the files. It could be iCloud Drive or Google Drive, so it's very easy to exchange the data between the different apps. Here you can see how we can optimize a 2D grid. And since iOS 14, it's also easy to have access on iCloud Drive. Now let's see how we can make a 3D full spherical grid for photogrammetry with only a few waypoints. So we have only two clicks for the radius and the rest is calculated automatic. I have optimized the DJI sample since the last video. Now I can import these CSV files directly into the app from the iCloud Drive. And I can import 3D or 2D. And I can simulate Virtual Stick and DJI Mutable missions with the same grids. So I built the point of interest on Virtual Stick. And we can see the simulation on the screen in the app and also on the simulator. So it's very important to use the simulator so we can do several times the same mission with different methods, and we can see how precise they really are. I did all these simulations with the Mavic Air 1 coincidence. With the Mavic Air 1, I have both capabilities for Virtual Stick, for all drones, or the DJI Mutable mission. So here we can see into the simulator and also on the screen how precise this point of interest works. So the point of interest on Virtual Stick is not very complicated. To control it is only a few lines. So we have the control of the bearing and also from the radius, the distance to the point of interest. And we can correct if there is something wrong with the flight path. On the bottom of the screen you can see the distance trigger. This distance trigger works into the Virtual Stick mission and also in the DJI Mutable mission. So for photogrammetry shootings I have always a 2D flat grid and then the semispherical point of interest grid with three circles. The advantage of the point of interest grid is that I have always the same distance to the target. and that gives us very precise 3D shootings, and it's also easy for the programs to calculate the 3D model. As you can see, I worked a little bit on the native MK map view from Xcode to have all these graphics on screen, so I can differentiate the waypoints. You can see I have only a few, and then the trigger for the pictures. And on this model, I can also export KML files into my new map builder. With that, I can check the altitudes. So that is very easy to use. I was a little bit surprised how precise we can do this stuff with Virtual Stick. And we will see later on 2D mapping the difference between inbuilt DJI missions and the Virtual Stick missions. What I also worked since last time, it's the radiuses. I have dynamic radiuses. We can see that later in this video, how it works. Now I restarted the mission, and this time it's the inbuilt DJI mutable mission. I choose half of the max velocity. That's important to have enough time between two pictures. You have to calculate 2 seconds for JPEG and 5 seconds for raw images. Here you can see the point of interest DJI mutable function on Xcode. It's only about 10 lines to do it. It's important to note that I use not the inbuilt DJI mutable mission distance trigger. With the inbuilt trigger from DJI SDK, I can only have access on single photo shooting. But if you program your own trigger, you can have access on AEB or other stuff on the camera. I use a timer to have this distance trigger. And as I do not trigger all the milliseconds, there is some small difference between the distances, but that's not very important for the final shooting. You can see on this 3D shooting that on each circle the pitch angle changes, so that the camera is always focusing the center of the point of interest. So now we have seen the 3D point of interest. Now let's switch to the 2D missions. So that's the 2D mission pass with dynamic radiuses. For these 2D missions, I can also export a KML file to see it in Google Earth to check the altitudes. But now let's focus on the radiuses. So we have dynamic pass. With dynamic pass, I adapt the radiuses depending on the angle between the two bearings. We will see that later in details. And that's the same system if we use inbuilt DJI mutable missions. They also adapt their radiuses to be quicker, faster, and more direct on the pass. So here you can see on the simulator the blue lines from the two missions. And for research and optimizations, it's very good to have this simulator. We can compare the flight paths and optimize our code to have the best results. The DJI Air 1 is not the fastest to do the simulations. The newer aircrafts are much more precise also into the simulations and also on the missions. But it's always interesting to use an older drone. And compared to the Air 2, the Air 1 has mission capability. So if you have a close look in the app or on the simulator, we can see that the inbuilt DJI mutable function overdrives a little bit in the curves. So that's very interesting to see. Now we can see how it goes back on the blue line. And that's what I call adaptive curve dynamic. So you can change the radiuses to have more speed and also decrease the radiuses if the angle alpha between the two bearings is too small. That's very important to optimize the mission pass. You can see here what was a big overdrive. Now let's see this curve, also a big overdrive. So that's the difference between own programmed virtual stick, where you can be very precise, or the inbuilt very fast function. I have also a timer on the top on the screen, so I can compare the speed with the two mission methods. But as you know, speed is not all. It's very important that we are precise. So this was one of the main reasons why I built the map curator, to have optimized grid paths. And now we will finish the mission, go to the center point. You can see here on the blue screen that this was a big overdrive too from the inbuilt mission. So with the inbuilt mission from DJI, it's all in the aircraft, the whole calculation of the flight path. And with virtual stick, it's on your mobile, the calculation and the correction for the flight path. That's very important to know. Here you can see how I export CSV for Litchi. And here we can see again how I control the point of interest in virtual stick mode, the bearing and the radius of the flight path. Today Litchi has not this capability to calculate grids. So here you can see an outline from a mission, but I can import it and then fill it up with a grid. It's very easy to do that with some mathematics. In the first virtual stick video, I used the star path to simulate the virtual stick functionality. Now I will show you how I fill it. I fill it with a grid. This grid is simple mathematics. And then we have to see which point is inside the grid. And as we will not use all these waypoints, I will just simplify all the points who are on a direct path. And at the end, I have 35 waypoints only for this 2T mission. I use a timer for the distance trigger. Then I measure the difference between the last waypoint position and the actual aircraft position. And if this distance is higher than my flight path trigger, I reset it to zero and take the picture. The main goal to do all this is to have optimized photogrammetry missions. As you can see on this picture, I took it last year. It was a combination of 3D semispherical and 2D flat grid. Today I have a simple grid generator into my apps, but with the map creator I built here, it will be much more comfortable to edit grids. So it's easy to optimize the flight paths, and we can save them and use it in the iCloud. And with the CSV export, you have full access on the whole data. Another advantage of the map creator are the inceptions. Now we can build them on the map. We can simulate them in the Google Earth. And you can use it also on Litchi with CSV import, so it's very easy to do. You can see the simulation on Google Earth. And here you can see the final result of this shooting. So it's quite amazing what we can do with Inceptions. I hope you enjoyed this video. Until the next time, thanks for watching.